Hi everyone, this is the third video in the series of recordings about using a decision tree for visual analysis of alternative project decisions under uncertainty. In the two previous videos, we talked about developing the model logic and also transferring that logic into an Excel spreadsheet. We also entered input and probabilities for the model. In this video, we will talk about finding the optimal strategy in the decision tree analysis and also conducting sensitivity analysis. As you can see in the Excel spreadsheet, now our model is complete and we have also the decision tree completed. I have made a very small change into our model and changed the probability of competitor bid value for bidding values between $1.8 million and $1.9 million to 30%, and the probability of competitor bid value for more than $1.9 million to 15%. As a result, the probability of winning for bidding value equal to $1.9 million is now 15% for our company. Let's have a look on our model, and you can see which one is the optimal strategy for this problem. As you can see in the model, precision tree has shown the optimal strategy in our decision making problem by labeling the best or optimal strategy with the true label. As you can see, the best option or the optimal strategy here is to bid for the project, and the optimal value is $1.8 million. We can also check the expected monetary value or EMV for this optimal strategy, which is equal to $136,000, and this value is more than EMV for two other decision options, which are $110,000 and $84,000. Precision tree also offers two more options for examining the optimal strategy, and these are risk profiles and optimum strategy or policy suggestion. We can select the decision analysis option in the menu bar of Precision Tree software, and in this one we have two options of risk profile and suggested policy. When we select risk profile, it shows us the probability of gains and losses from following the optimal decision policy. By accepting the default settings in the window, you can now see the results for risk profile. In this figure, you can see there is 45% chance of losing $60,000 and also 55% chance of gaining $290,000. The average for these two, weighted by different probabilities attached to them, is equal to expected monetary value for this decision option, which is $136,000. There is a second tab in this window for the cumulative chart, which we can see the same results. In the statistical summary tab, we can see first statistical moment, which is the mean value, $136,000 as the expected monetary value. The second statistical moment, which is standard deviation, and the third statistical moment, which is the skewness, and finally fourth statistical moment, which is kurtosis of this decision problem. By selecting the policy suggestion in decision analysis in the menu bar, you can see this window, and it gives you a summary about the best decision in this problem. As you can see, the optimal choice is to bid for the project, and the optimal value is $1.8 million. We are expecting to receive a benefit of $136,000 as a result of this bidding. In the second tab of this window, we can see the optimal decision tree, and as you can see, it is the subtree that gives you the most beneficial result in terms of expected monetary value. It is a useful tool in reporting results from decision tree analysis. Now this is time to cover the last step in decision tree analysis, and it is sensitivity analysis. When we have this input section in our model, and these are cell referenced in decision tree, it is very easy to conduct a sensitivity analysis because we don't have to manipulate the values manually. For conducting the sensitivity analysis, we have this option in the menu bar, and if you select this, a window will open that you can have your input and output for sensitivity analysis defined in it. As you can see in the top part of this window, we have analysis type, and two options of one-way and two-way are in here. First, we started one-way because we have one output and one input for this sensitivity analysis. For the starting node in the output section, you can select any of output values in your decision tree which is important to you, and you want to find out changes in that output because of alterations in different input variables. Here we can start selecting C27 cell, which is how much to bid. Now we need to define an input variable for this one, so we can add this one, and let's select the cost of completion of the project as the input cell, and then press OK. So it asks us how much do you want to make variation in this input variable, and by default it is -25% as the minimum change and +25% of the base value as the maximum change. Which is acceptable because the base value that was defined by us is $1.45 million. So we press OK, and now this input is can be seen in here. For results, we have two options of seeing sensitivity graph or strategy region. The most important graph for us is strategy region. And then we can press OK. The results can be seen shortly. First, we have this graph on the vertical axis of this sensitivity graph. We have expected values, and on the horizontal axis, we have cost of completion for the project. As you can see, it is symmetrical around its center, which was $1.45 million as the cost of completion, and we have ±25%. There is a second tab, a strategy region, and we can select this. Very interesting results in here. As you can see, we have different colors for different amounts of bidding, blue for 1.7, red for $1.8 million, and green for $1.9 million. Because on the horizontal axis we have negative values, the biggest cost of completion can be seen on the left, and by moving towards the very right end, we have a minimum cost of completion. At the beginning, when the cost of completion is around $1 or $1.1 million, The best value to bid is $1.7 million. By increasing the cost of completion, $1.8 million bid becomes a better option. And you can see from around $1.2 million cost of completion to around $1.7 million cost of completion, it is the optimum strategy. But after that, when the cost of completion exceeds $1.7 million and until the end, $1.9 million bid is the optimum strategy for bidding. So we can see the sensitivity of this output bidding decision based on variation in one of the inputs, which is cost of completion for the project. Another way of conducting sensitivity analysis is to select a two-way analysis type. And this means that you can have more than one input variable and observe the results of variation in these input variables on your output. For example, here we have one input, which is the cost of completion, but we can add some more. And for example, let's select the probability of competing bids as the second input variable. So again, it asks how much variation we want to make in this one. The maximum change by default is 25%, but we have the base value as 80%, so the maximum value will be more than 100%. We can reduce this one maybe to 10%. So we have minus 25%, it means 55% chance of competition, and the maximum change is 10%, it means 90% chance of competition. We can also reduce the steps maybe to 9 and then select this one. Now you can see we have two inputs here. You can even have more inputs and add another one. For example, it can be the cost of placing a bid, which is $60,000 at the moment. But for sensitivity analysis, we will set the minimum change to minus 25% and maximum change to plus 25% with 11 steps in alterations. Now we have three input values in our table. We can select X and Y axis for two-way sensitivity analysis. X axis in this case is the cost of completion, and for Y you can select any of these. For example, let's go for chance of competition. Now we have two inputs selected, and we want to conduct a two-way sensitivity analysis. This window shows a surface chart as a result of conducting the sensitivity analysis, and in the second tab of this window we have this very interesting strategy region for the optimal decision. As you can see, for different values of probability of competition and the cost of completion, different bidding values become optimal decision. As you can see on the left side, $1.9 million bid is good because we have higher cost of completion. Moving towards the right region of this graph, other values are becoming the optimal strategy. Now we have covered the different steps of a decision tree analysis, covering five steps in this analysis, and it is now clear to us which one is the optimal strategy in this example. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel for weekly new videos on engineering and project management. Thank you.